The story is about an astronaut named Molly Woods. She goes to space on a 13-month solo mission, and she doesn't come home alone.
You were on the Seraphim station for 13 months, a solo mission.
Yes.
You were alone the whole time. You're pregnant.
And meanwhile on Earth, her husband is a pioneer in robotics and advanced artificial intelligence, and he's created this new being called a humanic, which is a very lifelike robot. The idea that he created them with was imbuing them with a sense of humanity. If we want to make machines more human, if we want to bridge that divide between human and machine, we have to give the machine the human experience.
The camera's on. Say hello.
Hello.
And so when she returns home with this thing, she returns home to a family that's already extraordinary in their own way.
When she's been away from her family for a year, as you can imagine, there's some adjustment issues coming back into the family, into her world again.
He is not the same as when I left here.
No, he's not. He's a year older.
That is not what I'm talking about. She left a little robot boy that her husband created because they had infertility problems, and it's about trying to reconnect with that robot.
Watching Halle Berry work, you realize how little you have to do sometimes as a writer because she can do so much with her face and so much with her eyes.
I mean, I'm playing an astronaut, so I wanted to bring as much credibility to that as I possibly could. And when I met a few female astronauts, I realized this really is believable. These women were not so far away from who I am. Their mothers, their wives, and I thought I can relate to that. So I sat down and talked to them. They gave me every bit of information they could possibly squeeze into my brain about what it's like to be an astronaut. I took a zero-G gravity flight just to get that sense memory in my body. That was really important for me to pull off those zero-G scenes that we do in our show. The details make it feel, you know, hopefully will make it feel real for the audience.
We wanted to really show a world where nature is preserved and treasured. So you'll see that it's not a very synthetic future.
Steven Spielberg is, you know, one of the masters of the genre and has done it so well.
Steven's very much been an influence in terms of drawing from his aesthetic. The world that Mickey created and the one that Steven really pushed us to create is one where there's an emotional credibility. It's not a super heightened world. So you need actors who can play characters who you can connect to and relate to. So much of our story is about people trying to connect to each other and the kind of this question of what is human seen through different angles.
When I talk about you today, I'm gonna talk a bit about how you were originally created for the program, but it doesn't mean I don't see you as real.
What is it that makes us human? What are those defining characteristics, or is there a single one that shows what we are as human? It plays out in the Ethan story, for sure, in terms of trying to raise him in the most human possible way.
Can I have some now?
Absolutely not.
And it plays out in the alien story as well. Why do they want to come here? What do they want from us? Is it our nitrogen in our soil? Or is it something much more concrete and on a core level, what about our humanity? And we argue that it is the latter, and that's what our show's about, is this kind of intersection of people looking from every different angle about the question of what makes us human. And it's this kind of unlikely trio of the astronaut, the AI pioneer, and their humanic son that starts our story.